Hello and welcome back to another video. Today we're creating this animated topographic background. So yeah, I'm finally back after a little break. I'm not going to go into detail why, but if you want to know more, you can check the pinned comment down below. But in this video, we're going to use Photoshop, Illustrator and After Effects to create this animated background. You can also download the project file from the description below if this video reaches 800 likes. So before we start, don't forget to give this video a like, subscribe if you haven't already, and without further ado, let's get right into it. Alright, so we're going to start off in Photoshop, and I'm just going to make a document that is 1920 by 1080, resolution of 72, and background color could be black. Click create, and just unlock our layer, and go to straight to filter, and then render and clouds. Then we're going to go back to filter again and select blur, then Gaussian blur, and have the value around 20. Click OK. Then we're going to go down here to our adjustment layers and we're going to select posterize. And as you can see, we almost get the effect that we want. I'm just going to up the levels a bit to around 15. Yeah, so just like that. Then you can press down shift and select both layers, and then control and E to merge them. Great, so now we're going to go back to filter one more time and go to stylize and then find edges. And here we basically have the effect that we want, that, you know, with the topographic lines and all that. So this part is like really easy. We're just going to import this into Illustrator so we can get some vector lines that we then can animate inside of After Effects. So just go ahead and press down Ctrl and A and then Ctrl and C to copy it. We can then just close down Photoshop if you want and then open Illustrator. Here we're just going to create a 1920 by 1080 document. We can just paste it in from Photoshop. Great, so basically this is right now a PNG or just like a JPEG, just not transparent at all. So we're going to make it transparent, and this is really easy. Just go to Window and then Image Trace. Make sure this is selected with like is a simple select tool. Increase the threshold to the max. Not max, let's see, maybe like 249. Drop down to advanced and drag down the paths all the way to 1%, and drag the corners to 0% and the noise to 1 pixel. Make sure that we create strokes and not fills, and the strokes could be set around 10 pixels. And click off this box and click ignore white, and then just click trace. Computer will probably work for a little bit for a while, and just like that we have made it into like vector lines. As you can see, it's still a still image, but we want to create paths from these lines. Let's go to object, image trace, and expand. And then you can see you can select every path for itself. Great. So if you want to, you could spend a little time in Illustrator to create more of a, like a topographic line effect with maybe some like dotted lines and remove some that you don't want. But I'm just going to keep it simple and leave it as it is. So just go ahead and save this file or this document as whatever you want. You can just save it as lines. And just click save. Okay, and you will have it saved just like any like PSD. Then we can close down Illustrator and then open up After Effects. Alright, so in After Effects we're going to create a new composition. 1920 by 1080, you can have the frame rate at 60, duration to whatever you want, let's keep it at 10 seconds, and the background color doesn't really matter, but we can keep it black. Click OK. And first off, we're going to create a gradient. So you just go to new solid, and it can just be a black solid. Then go to effects and presets. Just let load. And then search up gradient ramp. There we go, just drag it to your black solid. And set the ramp shape to radial ramp. And we want the end color to be this hex code. I will all the hex codes in the description if you want to use the same. And the other one should be this one right here. And then we can import the Illustrator file that we just saved. Just drag it into a composition. Then we can right click on our file and go to create. Create shapes from vector layer. And it will load. And it will create shapes. So then we can just delete our main file. Skip that. We will keep it for now, but yeah. So if you drop down, you can see in the go to contents, you can see it has made a group of like every little line, or like maybe like this one here is line. So basically what you want to do is just select every group, because it's a lot of groups. Like in my case it's like 170 groups. And you can see it's a lot, but we basically just want to animate a few. So you can just select everyone and just click on the eye to make them disappear, and just like randomly like select a few lines here and there that you want to animate. And try to select like longer lines, because yeah, just easier. So often those at the bottom of the groups are, you know, bigger. So yeah, I'm going to animate these lines. So for the rest of the hidden groups, you can just delete them. And I'm not going to use any of these, so I'm just going to select them and delete them. Great. But, and that's why we kept those lines from the beginning, because this is just going to be still and we're going to animate these lines. So go to our effects and presets again and search up invert and drag them to both our line files. So you can see they are white. You could of course change this in Illustrator if you want. So you can just highlight or show both, and we're going to change the blending mode to overlay. Just to make these lines stand out a bit more, I'm going to add a layer style. Let's see, outer glow. Go down to outer glow, you can set the color to be like just, you know, quite bluish. Yeah, makes him stand out a bit more. That's cool. Great. So we're going to start off by animating this group. So just select it. Then add. We're going to animate a trim path for the group. So go down to the trim path, and we're going to set the start value to 100%. Make a keyframe for it. Move forward a little bit, maybe like 2 seconds. And we're going to drag down the start value to 0% again. Move back to 0 seconds, but move forward a little bit. And we're going to make a keyframe for the end as well. Move forward, but past the first keyframe, so we get a little bit of an offset. And we're going to set the end value to 0. So let's just going to play it out and see how it looks. Right, so you can see it animating like in a path, you're just like showing the path, but quite fast. So you will have to like time it a little bit better. Maybe take these 2 keyframes at the end, drag them further away. This means that the animation will take longer to finish, basically. So, and if you want the lines to be smaller, just drag these keyframes closer to each other, and let's see how that looks. Still kind of fast, just check it out, play around, then you can just press down F9 to ease, which will make the animation just a little bit smoother, as you can see. So basically, when you're happy with the animation, just select all the keyframes, Control C, we can show another group, just Control V, and that will paste the keyframes at the same place. You see, now we have two lines animating. And I'm just going to do this with every group. So select the group, Control V to paste it, select a new group, Control V, so let's play it out. Right, so as you can see, we have all the lines animating at the same time. To make the animation a little more smooth and more natural, you can just go back to where we have pasted all the keyframes to this layer right here, the outlines. Just press U, you can see all the keyframes that we have made. So right now we have the animation starting at the same time and ending at the same time, which, if that is what you're after, well, great, but I'm just going to take some time to tweak this a little bit, like move them around here and there. So let's see how that looks. Alright, looks better, but I think some of these longer lines, they move quite fast, so... And I'm just basically doing this at random, so there's not really any like thought process going in to how I'm moving the keyframes. So maybe let's see how this looks. So I think that looks really cool. I think it's a little bit too bright, this gradient, so I'm just going to add a curves layer to make the lines stand out quite a bit more. So we're just going to right click, add a new adjustment layer. We can put it below our animating lines. And we're just going to add a curves layer. Just like drag this down. Like that, let's see how that looks. But yeah, so I think this looks kind of cool. You could of course spend a little more time on it, you know, get it perfect. But that is just like a quick way to animate some topographic lines. Like I mentioned before, it would be cool if some of the lines were like dotted or maybe thicker than others. So it just depends on how much time you spend on the piece. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If this video gets 800 likes, I will leave all the project files in the description for you to download. So yeah, I'll see you in the next video. Bye.